What's going on? I'm Kevin Hart, and this is season 4 of Cold as Balls, The Bubble. Ha! In your face, NBA. What's up, man?
Johnny.
How you doing, bro?
Good, how about you?
I'm good, man. Good to see you.
You're looking taller than
tall
you.
Tall as
Yeah.
Tall as
Looking good,
it's
bro.
Been a minute, but you see it, little growth spurt.
It happened late, but better late than never.
And honestly, you better be lucky this growth spurt hit when it did, because if it had came sooner, I would have been on your ass.
Right. Oh,
hooping.
Okay.
Hooping. Take the robe off, put it on the side, man.
Got it, man.
Boogie, my God. Question is, which ones are we going to get into? How you doing, man? How you
feel? I said this wasn't cold.
Welcome to an all-new episode of Cold as Balls. I'm with my brother, Boogie, DeMarcus Cousins. First, how's your attitude, Boogie?
Better, man.
Don't come here with no
You got it.
People don't know that you're actually a nice guy.
I don't know what it is, man.
Do you feel like you're misunderstood?
Yeah, but at this point, I mean, I don't even really care
anymore.
You
don't care. You don't care.
I mean, people gonna have their opinion about you if it's good or bad, you know? No matter if you're doing good or bad, so. It is what it is.
It is what it is. Was Boogie Cousins always a aggressive competitor on the basketball court?
I was. And the reason with that is, I mean, I was always a taller kid. So I was always forced to play with, you know, guys older and bigger.
How many techs did you have in high school?
I'm not sure, bro.
Was it a lot?
Nah, it wasn't that many.
It wasn't crazy.
It started in the league.
The tech craze started in the NBA. At this point in your career, you know, I think the priority, of course, is a ring.
Absolutely.
Going to Golden State, that was an opportunity for you to do just that.
Right.
You get there, this is supposed to be it.
Right.
Then it wasn't. What is going on in your head at that point, man?
You know, obviously, I'm disappointed. For some reason, adversity has always been a part of my life. So, that being said, I've kind of been built up to, you know, handle these type of situations.
Exactly.
So, you know, obviously, I go through my little pity parties. Most humans do, and you know, I get back to work.
From the guys at Golden State at that time, you feel like there was some support?
Absolutely. I was actually just at Draymond's baby shower.
I heard he had on a dumbass outfit. One of the
always,
worst dresses.
Always.
One of the worst dresses. Yeah. I want to say that on f***ing Cold as Balls. Breaking news here. Draymond Green will put on some of the worst f***ing outfits. I don't know who is suggesting this s***, but he literally, it makes my balls itch how bad he dresses, but he's such a good guy.
Love that dude to death.
So what about your career inspired you to, like, you know, get that level of confidence that you have now?
Oh no, I was kind of always taught, like, you know, confidence is kind of instilled in yourself.
The thing with me is, I think where my confidence comes from is Old Spice, Sweat Defense.
Just had to throw that in there.
Throw what?
Just
what?
Working while you're working, huh?
Not working at all. I just so happen to have my Old Spice Sweat Defense to the left side of me as we were talking about confidence. Not a plug at all.
Gotcha.
Before Golden State, you got a great situation on your hands as well. You know, you and a combination of AD. What was New Orleans for you? What was that?
New Orleans was, you know, finding that joy again. You know, my previous stand before New Orleans, it wasn't really a situation, you know, building to win. So being put in that position and actually having a franchise that was, you know, trying to win and put the pieces together.
What the f- just bam bam what bam bam what and v f- I'm sorry, Boogie. By the way, Boogie, how you get the nickname Boogie?
You know, I know you heard of Rod Strickland.
Yeah, what do you mean, have I heard of Rod Strickland?
That's who gave me my name.
One of the goddamn greatest point guards to ever do it, not talked about enough, honestly.
Absolutely.
I thought you picked your nose.
Nah.
Were you a Boogie picker?
Not anymore.
Boogie picking is fine. Eating them is the problem. You didn't do that, did you?
Nah, that wasn't really my stop.
That's a big man trait, too.
No, it's not. Actually.
Yeah, it is, because big men don't have places to flick them, which is why they get comfortable.
No.
And they end up just eating it, because they, where do I put it?
You just made all that up.
I didn't make it up. I got
you
a cousin that's 6'8".
You got a cousin 6'8"?
I got a cousin that's 6'8" on my dad's side. I don't got time to talk to you about this. Okay, what we're going to do now is take things to the next level. Questions get bigger, and we get deeper. Come on, man. Sit in a little bit more. Huh? Oh, yeah. Look at this shit. For the first time, that tub is overflowing. God, look like your tub is pissing.
Well, everybody can't sit in a bowl of water.
All right, well, that's just, that's everything, man.
All right.
What are you doing, man? Ah, smart. Save that water, and then you know what we can do? We can reuse that for one of the other guests. We'll freeze this, make more ice out of it. We're on a budget because of the bubble. We don't reuse it. We're reusing it. Let's talk about your love for comedy, man. You do your own specials. You've been doing them quite some time. What's the name of them?
Boogie's Comedy Slam.
Boogie's Comedy Slam. Where does the love for comedy come from?
Just growing up in my household, I can remember being a kid and, you know, watching Comedy with my mom.
Mm-hmm.
Man, it was probably some of the best times of my life. Just that whole, you know, vibe of, you know, family being together, laughing, enjoying one another's company. It's also creating a platform for a lot of people.
A lot of up and comings. I remember Shaq had his. That's honestly.
That's who inspired me.
The Shaq's All-Star Comedy Jam.
I know.
That's where I took off from.
Mm-hmm.
So Shaq doing that created an opportunity for me that became something that was stupid above and beyond. I think you're doing the same exact thing. What are you doing? What are you doing? What is your... Man, what the... What are you doing, man? Well, I know what he's trying to do. He's trying to make my tub. See how yours is? Your tub basically looks stupid. So he's trying to make me match your stupid.
Hmm.
And it's fine. It's fine.
Let's get all the way in.
Yep, done. I'm about to do the same thing.
Do that.
Right here. Got it.
Yeah.
Here's a question for you, man. How many tattoos you up to now?
One.
That's more than one tattoo.
I mean, it's basically one now.
What was your last tattoo?
I got a tattoo the night before my wedding.
The night before your wedding? What the f*** is your... I swear to God, I'm about to kick your f***ing glasses off. You want me to kick your frames off your face? Because that's what's going to happen.
This is crazy.
You know what? Maybe, I don't know. Maybe I can fix it in the edit. I don't think I can. Okay, I'm going to be honest with you. Okay, so just f***ing deal with it.
All right.
Okay, all right. Congrats on the wedding, man.
Appreciate that.
I didn't get an invite. Yeah, yeah, that was weird.
Where was my invite?
To what?
Your wedding.
I sent you an invite. You don't have your Hotmail address anymore? You don't have that address anymore?
No, I don't.
You not boogie@hotmail.com?
That's not me.
Well, then whoever that was showed the f*** up at the wedding because that plate was accounted for. Okay, so I don't know what you're talking about. Where you at right now health-wise?
I'm pretty close to being 100%.
Yeah.
Working my tail off every day. The pandemic did not stop my process at all.
You know, we've been working out here.
I'm gonna be ready to go for next week.
If you want, because we got a nice thing going on here in this bubble. Nobody's getting in, but we got a full-on gym set. We get shots up. As you can see, Bam is dropping weight like f***ing. I mean, it's like bacon coming off his back. Bam, how much you down now? 4 pounds. And that's since we've been here. We've been in this pandemic for 6 months.
Mm.
And I'm the one putting him through the workouts.
Right. Well, I got some questions for you.
Done deal, man.
How many All-Star games in a row?
4.
Okay.
Ha!
Listen.
Boy, you didn't think I knew it. That's real. Like, I ain't had every goddamn All-Star weekend that there's been.
How many gold medals do I have?
2. Yeah. What an idiot. Yeah. There we go. That's what I'm talking about. Hey, Daryl, he said, how many All-Star games? And then after that, he said, how many gold medals? I got it, man. No.
What's my career high point score?
Career high point score, I think for sure. 52. You bullshit.
Nah.
Point scored?
Yeah.
Wait a minute, you didn't have a 52 point game? Hold on, wait. God damn, that was on 2K. Hey, motherfucker, let us finish the conversation.
56.
Get I know basketball. You don't get your Donald's left. Bam, I swear to you. Okay, you could be drinking bath water when I put your face in this tub. Do you hear me? You got one more time. I knew it was a 50-point game is what I'm trying to tell you. Mm-hmm. Okay? Now, get your Donald Glover looking up out of here. Get out. Sorry about that. One more.
What was the name of my documentary that came out last year?
First of all, congrats, because it was good. Strong, brother. Okay? And let me tell you something. The fact that you covered everything you covered.
What's the name?
All right, are you ready?
Yeah.
It was called Boogies. Whose nose are you picking? The true story. Ah, that's exactly what it was.
Let's
okay.
Get this
all right. All right. All right. All right. Just fat bit. When he leaves, cause I'm not gonna do it in front of company, cause you ain't gonna know what the f- hits you. This whole pandemic, you've been showing out. Showing out. Boogie, before we get out of here, what's the tally? How much are you up to in NBA fines?
I haven't really kept up, man.
I kept up. I clocked you at $1.1 million through the course of your career in NBA fines. Mm. Let me tell you something about fines here on Coldest Balls. You're not getting paid at all for today. So you can take whatever check you thought you had, and you can f-ing kiss it goodbye. And you're not getting a goddamn nickel for your time today. And you can be right behind him, Mr. Chaplips, so sick of your dry mouth. I told you about that. Moisture is what we pride ourselves on, and you have forgotten about it. Now, Bam Bam, I want to get out of here on a nice note. Throw me that basketball right there. I just want to show. There you go.
Okay.
Right. You want to work out, do anything, just let me know. Do you know I got a handle?
Show me. Show me something, man.
Y'all can play defense right now. Come on, get in front. Get out the tub so you can be on my team. You just go stand back there, okay? Play defense, all right? Yeah, stay right there.
Okay.
That's all the place I need you to be. Yeah, there you go. You ready? Okay. Now, if I was on your team, this is how I would run the team. Are you ready?
Yeah.
Just tell me you open.
I'm open.
Get the f*** out the way. That's right. I don't need you nowhere near me. As a matter of fact, everybody on the court, get the f*** out the way, because I'm about to do him. Ooh. When I say go, ball, okay? Ready? Go. Ooh. Oh! Come on now.
Okay.
I'm walking to the basket.
Okay.